Didn't even start and already messed up. You guys, I cannot with this eye. Ugh, it's in my eyes again. Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So, today we are continuing this series of Zodiac sign makeup and hair. I gave up on the outfit. I don't have a pink jacket. I don't. And yeah, happy Easter if you're celebrating this week, and well, if you're celebrating next week, then I will wish you then. So for the hair, I think it's more about the color than the style. It's just loose hair, but she has a really pretty color. The makeup is interesting. It's a very nice long wing, easier on the eyeshadow. I don't have glitter, so let's see how that's gonna work out. And yeah, the lipstick are really cool, like this bloody red kind of thing. I really like it. I fixed my lights. Well, at least I think so. I hope it looks better this time, and I will try not to lean in so much so that you can actually see what I'm doing. And yeah, let's see what happens. Without any further ado, let's get into it. So again, I'm not gonna be using primer because of the reasons of staying at home. And I'm gonna start with the foundation. I will do a skincare routine because a good friend asked me for one, but maybe I will do it like one day, like in between the videos or after this. I'm not sure yet. I will get to it, I promise. So for foundation, I'm using my regular combination of 2N and 3N from True Match from L'Oreal. So, concealer, perfect match again. L'Oreal. I probably look like a ghost now with this light because I got a really strong light. I did not want that yellow light again. I really, really hate how it looks on camera. And I'll probably look like a ghost, but yeah, I'm setting this with powder. And I'm actually gonna set the entire face because I don't wanna get back to it later. So what you guys been up to lately? Now that everybody's on lockdown, or most of the people. To do anything interesting, let me know down below. Yeah, eyebrows are already on. They came out a bit dark this time. I actually didn't even pass much the pencil on them, but yeah, it's just the contrast with the blonde hair and they look quite dark, but it's what we have. At least they're kind of even, at least in the mirror. I don't know on camera, I don't see what I'm doing. So what do we do next? I think we're gonna start with the shadow, and so let's prime the eyes a bit and she has some kind of like an orangey brown thing in her crease and a bit of pink underneath. I'm gonna go with this palette, the what's it called even? Professional Makeup Value Markers. Don't know. I'm gonna go for this one, this color here in the crease. I hope you could see that. Wish I would see what I'm doing, but I don't. So here we are. That is way stronger than I wanted it to be. I'm using the color next to it, which is this. It needs to be a little bit less red and a bit more brown, orange, nude thing. Didn't even start and already messed up. It's in my eyes again. Don't know how I always manage that. I just do. I'm gonna blend it with the fluffy brush. I hope it goes away a little because it's too strong. One time I don't want it to be so strong. It is. It's really hard to see because I think she has like a hooded eye kind of thing, and she has some sort of line over there, darker, but I'm not sure which color that is, like this dark color. So I'm just gonna go with some kind of brownish, reddish. This, can you see? That's not dark enough. I'm gonna go for the brown. So I'm combining browns over here. These three. No, these three. And I'm trying to create this effect what she has, and then I'm gonna attempt again this cut crease thing. Why does this eye never work? And a little more blending. I'm gonna take a wet wipe, because on the left eye, as always, it never works correctly. Sorry for the noise. And just gonna do that, and then I will fix it with a little bit of concealer also. So I left the under eye empty for now. I'm gonna pass with first with this reddish color brown, and then with this glitter thing that she has. I will try to use this color for that. It's some kind of rosé thing with some glitter, shimmery. Yeah, this isn't near enough shimmery as it should be, or as it looks here. I guess I'll just have to put a lot. Does it shine yet? There's probably not much hope for that. I'm just gonna check the other palettes, but... nope. Here we have something that could work. God, I hope the angle of the camera is good because I cannot see anything. I covered the mirror behind it with a light and I don't see nothing now. Okay, I guess we will circle back to this and see how it would work. So here, she doesn't have like exactly a cut crease, but she does have a white eyelid, or like a very light pink. I'm gonna try. You guys, I cannot with this eye. It hates me. I'm gonna cover it up later, and I don't know. Now I'm gonna go with the light pink. Sorry, I'm not even looking up into the camera because I'm afraid I will smear this all over the place. Pink. Oh, that's a shiny pink. not, is it? Well, I have some pink here and I'm gonna try it. Yeah, this is very pale, it's good. And as I covered too much of what I did in the crease, then I have to go over it again, back and forth. And now I'm going back in with the browns. Okay, it's maybe a bit too pink, but it's fine. Passing some white on top of it, some cream actually. Yeah, that works, I like it. And now fluffy brush blending. This dark brown doesn't like to blend much. Okay, and a little bit of white from some palette. This one for the inner corner. Wow, that looks pink. That's so strange. Because it's this one right here. And that's white. I guess it's on top of these colors creates this effect and makes that pink, like really pink. Okay, so now that we got the eyeshadow down, let's move on to eyeliner. And this is a really big eyeliner. It's what this is about. Let's see what mess do I do, because I have to use this funny one. Wow, in the picture this goes beyond the eyebrow. It looks ridiculous on me, so that's funny. But I do love eyeliner. This is crazy, it's so long. But that's how it is there. Like, her eyebrow stops here and the eyeliner goes up to the hair almost. This is way too long, I don't like it. And I made it too thick. I fixed my foundation and eyeshadow a little bit off camera, and I wiped it off, I made it a bit smaller. I will pass over it again, but first I just gotta fix the eyeshadow here, because I looked up and I smeared it. And I know better not to look up when I have liquid eyeliner on, but I was trying to talk to you guys. Still hate this one. We're struggling. It's so imprecise, this thing. God. I guess that's as good as it's gonna get, this eyeliner. And now I'm just gonna conceal the mess that I made. So, I think this is the eyeliner and the eyeshadow. I like it. I actually like it a lot. I did a bit more than what she has. Like, the color is a bit more intense, at least in the mirror, but I don't mind because I like it. And so let's go for contouring with the bronzer. I'm gonna use a combination of these two, mostly this one from Manhattan because it's a bit softer, like I mentioned last time. My cats don't stop meowing today. I had to stop the filming like 5 times to open the door for them. God. Actually, no, I'm actually going to use just this one, the soft one, because I want a soft contour today. Thank you. Yeah, I'm okay with that. So next, we're doing some highlighter. This one from Bipa, the white one, very liquid. We did bronze last week. I also didn't feel like putting too much strong bronzer because this look is a bit more red, and that dark bronzer doesn't match in my taste. Alright, I hope this looks good. Now we are doing mascara and eyelashes. Should have done the mascara before, but I didn't, so... Maybelline Lash Sensational, is it this one? No, wrong one. This one. Ugh, I put too much. It's getting dry. That's sad. Okay, that's fine. And we're gonna use the magnetic eyeliner, and we're gonna put... Does she even have lashes? Probably. We're going for the top ones this time, and last time they did not stay very good, so here's hoping for the best. This one makes such trouble, it always ruins my eyeliner after I spend hours on it. I don't like that, but okay. And for the lips, we have like a really velvety dark red. I don't even know if I own something like that. I do have a dark red lipstick, but I think I might have to combine it with some black or something. That's a really pretty color, and I need that lipstick. Let's overline. I do have a dark red liner, at least. And I'm using this lipstick from... What is this even? I have it for so long. I don't even know. It doesn't even say... Oh! Ultimate Stay Behind the red Curtain. Made in Italy. Cosnova? Cosnova? I don't know. Looks like this. I have it for a really long time, but it's a really nice lipstick. I enjoy it. And I'm just gonna add some black lipstick, dark, because this is like really dark red and so pretty, and I don't have it and I need it. So I always end up smearing the lipstick, so I'll just leave it like this. It's a mess. I had to conceal over and over, so I'm just gonna let it go. And so here we have the completed look. The hair, I leave it as it is because she had it like loose. I think it was about the color in that situation, and I cannot change my hair color for every video. I mean, I wish I had the wigs for it, but I have like 2 weeks, so. But anyways, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm actually happy with the result for once. Well, the lipstick could be better, but that's what I got. But the eyeshadow and the eyelashes I actually like. It's a nice combination. And yeah, I hope you guys also enjoyed it. Let me know down below in the comments what you think. If this is your zodiac sign, and if you would wear it, and if you will try it. And yeah, thank you again so much for watching. Please leave a like if you haven't already, and subscribe for more. I post every Saturday between 6 and 8 p.m. Central European time. I wish you a great day, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!